أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين خاتم النبيين رحمة للعالمين أبي القاسم محمد My dear brothers and sisters in Iman and in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is not an ordinary dua. It is a very extraordinary dua brought to us by a very extraordinary person, taught by one who is the Imam al-Muttaqin, who is the Amir al-Mu'mineen. And he brought it and said that I got it from a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Nabi Khizr. One thing that I found very, very enlightening is that we know of the Quran and the advent of Quran, which was on the night of Laylatul Qadr to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did Nabi Khidr know about أَفَمَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَمَنْ كَانَ فَاسِكًا لَا يَسْتَعُونَ? This is an ayah of the Quran. Did it exist? How did he get it? What was his quality? What were his qualities so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this verse of the Quran when the Quran was not, that was thousands of years ago. Please think about this. Reflect on it. And perhaps one fine day we'll be able to sit down and interact and find out what is it that Nabi Khidr had that gave him that privilege to be able to quote an ayah from the Quran which was revealed thousands of years later to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are beseeching Allah by His majesty, by His name, by His knowledge. And there is one interesting thing that we are asking Him with is, وَبِوَجْهِكَ الْبَاقِي بَعْدَ فَنَائِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. What is this face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And by your own self, that shall endure forever after all things have vanished. What does it mean? Everything is vanished, but his face, but his self. We find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the holy book is telling us, كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْزَلَالِ Well, Ikram, every one of you knows what it is all about, that everything will perish, everything, except the self that was and that will stay. That is the only eternal thing that has been and will be. It is beyond eternality, because you and I, we can become eternal. We can. Those who die fighting for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are not dead. They are alive and Allah is sustaining them. لا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. My problem is a very big problem. My problem is, yes, I understand about taqwa. I understand about the consciousness of having Allah all the time, every time, everywhere. My problem is, who is this Allah? If I know who this Allah is, then I will have taqwa for him. If I do not know him, then however many times may I be told about taqwa, fear, taqwa, this, taqwa, that, taqwa, consciousness, it will not be able to relate to me because I don't know him, huwa. Who is he? The Quran says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. He is Allah the One. We all know that. Allahu Samad, he is needful. Lam Yalid, he was never born, he never was begotten, he never begets. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا. There is nothing that is comparable to him. We read this every day in our salah. I don't know him. I want to know him. When I know him, then I will sit and not make this into a ritual. This dua will not become a ritual. This dua will become a ritual that will hit me in my heart. This dua will come into me and open me. And this dua will make me understand that the taqwa of Allah, whom now I know, if I do, then I'll be able to have that lutf, as they say. Without that, I don't have the lutf. So how am I going to know who is this Allah? We find that Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he's telling us, man arafa nafsahu faqad arafa rabbah. The one who understands himself, the one who is conscious of himself, the one who is subconscious of himself, the one who knows himself, the one who understands himself, he will understand Allah. So the ball is then back in my court, and my Amir, my Mawla, is telling me, go know yourself. Go and think about it. And once you know yourself, you will know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But my heart is locked. We are told in the Quran that this Quran is not only for the month of Ramadan. This Quran is for us always, constant. But this Quran says that those who do not reflect on the Quran, those who do not reflect on the Quran, am ala qulubihim akfaluha, are their hearts locked? So there is a lock and there is a heart, and the heart has a lock, and the lock needs to be opened through reflection. But how will I reflect? Is that the key? Reflection of the Quran is the key to open the lock of my heart so that I can open it and receive him. So how do I do it? I need a key. We have remote controls now. We open our cars remotely. We open our houses from our phones. Everything is remote. But we need some sort of apparatus to be able to open the lock. And for that, I need a key. That key of mine does not fit in the lock. It doesn't, because it is bent. You know why it is bent? Because araita man ittakhaza ilahahu hawa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, see those people who take their gods as their lusts and their desires. And this dua is all to do with that. We have three things that we have to reckon with, the three D's. One is desire, one is the devil, and the third is the dunya. The first one is myself. Araita man ittakhaza ilahahu hawa. Then how will I know this, the baqa of the wajh Allah, kullu man alayhi afar. I will not be able to relate to that, that I am going to be destroyed, that I am going to go, that I will vanish, that I will perish, that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remain. Because I still am wallowing, فَبِأَيِّ أَلَىٰ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Which ones of the Quran that will I deny? Which one of his blessing will I deny? So Amir al-Mu'mineen is coming to our rescue through Kumail, giving us this and saying, you read it only once in your lifetime, and if you read it with makini, is to say, with that kind of keenness, that your key fits the lock to open it of your heart, so that the Kumail dua enters me, and when it enters me, I see, wa biwajhika al-baqi ba'da fana'i kulli shay'. I say, I know that. وَبِي أَسْمَائِكَ الَّتِي مَلَأَ تَرْكَانَا كُلِّ شَيْنِ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي. And then at that point, once I recognize who is this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I'm saying to him, اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي الذُّنُوبَ الَّتِي تَحْبِسُ الدُّعَى. Oh Allah, forgive me my sins that prevent, that hinder my supplication. What are these sins that I have committed? Who knows them? Only I know it. I don't know what you have committed. I don't know what you have, but I know what I have committed. And I'm going to tell you that. But he's so loving. He is so loving. This, don't worry. I will forgive you everything. I have a story to tell you with my children. In Zanzibar, we had a room which is called Gala. Gala is a room where we put our things that we don't need. It has no window, it has no light, it has a door. And it can be only closed from outside and locked. Inside there is nothing. One day I did something which is, I'm just giving you a story, that a despicable thing was done by a child when he was told not to do it. Like Hazrat Adam was told, don't go near that tree. Yes? La takrabu haza shajara. Do not go there. But this boy, he did it because he was told, don't do that, and he goes and does it. What it was, I do not want to go through. But the mother comes and sees the child and says, I told you not to do this. Yes, mom, you did tell me. I'm sorry. What do you mean you are sorry? I told you again and again, don't take him and put him in that room. And now that boy is choking. He is crying, oh, my mom, please don't do this to me. I beg for your forgiveness. Please forgive me. I love you. He says, I love you too, inside. And the door is open and the boy is put into the child is put into the room and the door is closed and the child is choking. He can't breathe. He's calling his mother. Silence. He cannot even now, he just murmurs. He says, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. Silence. Suddenly the door opens and the child sees the mother with tears in her eyes, picks up the child, hugs the child, puts the child on his lap, strokes his head and says, it's okay, it's all right. What you have done, I have forgiven you. Mom, I will never do it again. This is the commitment the child made. I will never, ever commit it again. This is the love of the mother, which has no condition. This is the love that was given to the child. And the child has committed that he will never, ever do it again. Allah loves me so much. He loves me many, many more times than my mother. Will Allah not forgive me? Will he not forgive you? He says, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. This is when I read the Quran and when I open the lock and the key is not bent anymore. So now I have to concentrate on making my key straight. It does not happen in Home Depot. You can't go and get another key from Canadian Tires. The key is with you. You have to straighten it. I have to straighten it. I have to put it in the lock, open the lock, open my heart and say, Allah is telling me, La taqnatu min rahmatillah. He says, do not despair from my mercy. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. He is going to forgive you all your sins. Who is telling me that Allah will not forgive me my sins when my mother has forgiven me? You think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who loves me so much, will he not forgive me? Will he not forgive me? He will forgive me. But I have to make a commitment. The way I made commitment to my mother, I have to make that commitment completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unconditionally, without any restrictions, without any conditions. This is not a piece of article that I have between him and me and he signs and I sign, no. This is not a memorandum of understanding. This is my commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will not do it. And because I have been reading Dua Kumail, I understood who Allah is. I have come to recognize him. And I will put my desires on one side. I say, Allahumma fil li dhunuba allati tunzilu al-bala. Allahumma filli kulla dhanbin adhnabtu. We lived it last time. Kulla dhanbin adhnabtu. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Oh Allah, what have I done? Allahumma filli kulla dhanbin adhnabtu. Wa kulla khatiyatin akhta'tuha. Astashfi'u ila nafsik. And I pray to you, oh Allah, to intercede. I want Allah to intercede on my behalf. Wa as'aluka bijudika. Allahumma inni as'aluka su'ala khadim mutadhallil khashi'. Oh Allah, I am begging you submissively, humbly, awe-stricken. But the key is still bent. The key is still bent. The light of guidance and the ark of salvation, Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salatu wassalam. Is quoting his father, who says, I sought richness but did not find it. I did not find it except in contentment, in kana'a. So it is imperative for me to be contented and feel enriched. With contentment, I feel rich. With richness, I don't feel enriched. With contentment, I feel enriched. I sought for glory. I sought for position, but did not find them except in knowledge. Allahu khalaq Allahu, awwalu khalaq Allahu al-aql. With knowledge. For you to acquire knowledge, and it will secure your glory and position in both dunya and akhirah. I sought to obtain nobility, or I am so and so. And I could not find it except by taqwa, except by fearing Allah. Therefore, fear Allah to become noble and seek for tranquility, and you will find that you will leave the worldly people. When you leave those people who are after the worldly things, you will get that tranquility. That tranquility is there in the Quran. And Allah is saying to me, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutmainna, who is contented soul, tranquil soul, irji'i. People say, but this was only for Imam Hussein. Imam Hussein is my light. Imam Hussein is the ark of my salvation, and I am sitting on his ark. So that will not be me. Of course, it is going to be me and you, but we have to belong to Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Irji ila rabbiki, come to your Lord. The Lord is saying, come to your Lord. Your Lord is raziatan marziya. Fadkhuli fi ibadi, enter at my servant. Wadkhuli fi my heaven. Contentment is a treasure which does not exhaust. Contentment. Therefore, we were here when we said, Allahumma as'aluka su'ala man ishtaddat faqatu wa anzala baka inda shada'idi hajata wa azuma indaka raghbatu. O Allah, I beg you as the one who is passing through extreme privation. What extreme privation? Who supplicates his needs to you in his hope has been greatly raised, by which is you. I want. All the time I want. All the time it's not that I need. To need is something else, but wanting and wanting. And the more I want, the more I get. And I continue in that ritual. But let us not continue on the ritual. Let us continue on the spirit of this dua. Salawat bar Muhammad. Again, Aba Abdullah is quoting his father and saying that somebody came to his father, a man, and he says, I am a sinner, and I find it very difficult to resist temptation. I'm addicted to sin. Will you advise me what to do? So he tells him, sit down. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, he admonishes the man as follows, he says, sit down. If you possess the abilities of these five prerequisites, five, then you may commit any sin you like. Keep on committing. But you have to have these three prerequisites. First, stop partaking of sustenance provided by Allah. Huwa Razzaq. Go find your risk somewhere else, not from Allah. Second, get out of Allah's dominion. Everything belongs to Allah. Go find something else. Third, find a place where Allah does not see you. Here it reminded me of who? The story of Nabi Yusuf, when he was in the room locked by that woman. And when he says, I am afraid of my God, he's everywhere. You know what she did? She took a cloth, and there was her God there, a murti, an idol, and she goes and covers that with a cloth and says to Yusuf, he's not seeing us anymore. He says, maybe yours does not see you, but my God sees me. I may not see him, but my God sees me. So find a place where Allah does not see you. And fourth, acquire power to prevent the angel of death from taking away your soul. When he comes uninvited, anytime, anywhere, anytime, and he's everywhere, when he comes, you say, excuse me, go. I don't need you. You have that power? Commit sins. And fifth, gather the strength to resist the angel Malak in charge of hell, flinging you into the hell. You know, there are angels who will throw me in the hell, and I have to have that power to resist this. You cannot do that the way I just, no, you can't. I know what I can do. I know I'm smart, I know I'm clever, I know I'm rich, I know I'm authority, I know I have a car, I know I have a house, I know everything. You can't do that to me. So Amir al-Mu'mineen says, you have these five things, if you are able to have these five things, then you can sin as you like. Salawat bar Muhammad. La ilaha illa ant subhanak wa bihamdik. There is no God but you. Glory and praise be to you. Zalamtu nafsi. Wa tajarra'tu bijahli. I have made my soul to suffer. I had the audacity to sin by my ignorance. Zalamtu nafsi. I remember the one from whom we all came, Nabi Adam, when he went and he did that error. And immediately he's told, why did you go there on that tree? And he says that I was bamboozled by this one devil who swore in your name that you did not want me to have eternality. It is in the Quran. What I'm telling you is all in the Quran, that he did not want me to have the eternality. So I am swearing by God, go and eat it, you'll be eternal. And I went there in error. He said, you did it. He said, yeah. But he says, Rabbana zalamna anfusana. The same word, zalam. Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna minal khasirin. Oh Allah, I have done zulm on myself. And if you do not forgive me, and if you do not have mercy on me, you will find me from the losers. And that's where we will stop. Do I want to be a loser? Do I want to have that love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do I want to commit myself and make my key straight so that it fits in the lock? Let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us that ma'rifah to be able to be contented and keep away from those undescribable, unmentionable sins that we commit daily, that we commit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that as I committed to my mother, I'm committing to you that Allah, I will not do it anymore. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.